I am Dr. Ranjith Reddy. I have finished my post-graduation veterinary sciences in 1990. I, along with my partner Dr. Tirupati Reddy, who was my classmate in the college days, he has finished his graduation and I have finished my post-graduation. Then we have ventured into the business of poultry activity. Yeah, the first company what we floated was SR Hatcheries, which was in 1996. So basically the SR Hatcheries activities deals with the broiler breeding. So to cater to the requirement of the feed, we started Rohini Minerals in 1999. But during that stage, we were growing in SR Hatcheries. So we really did not take off the company of Rohini Minerals in 1999, and we were buying feed from outside. So by the time we grew in SR Hatcheries, it was 2004, wherein we have started Rohini Minerals, which caters the feed requirement of all the breeding forms. Honestly, to confess, when we started the business in 1996, it was a meager amount of around 2 lakhs by us, because we were working for 4-5 years, we never had a vision to start a breeding farm. But when we got the opportunity to start the breeding farm in 96, we started with that meager amounts. When we started this feed production business in 2004, there were only multinational companies which were operating the feed operations. So our basic position was, when the multinationals are buying the raw materials locally, and when they can cater the requirement of the poultry farmers of the Indian requirement, why not we? When we have the technical expertise, when we have the awareness of the nutrition, when we have the awareness of the requirement of the birds in India, why not we start as technocrats? That has motivated us, and initially they have tried to push us by not increasing the prices when the raw material prices have gone up. But we are not taken that seriously. We have incurred losses in the very first year, maybe for some time. But after that, they shied away from the competition, and now we are leading it. Well, please let me not think about it and don't remind about the bird flu. That was the worst phase what we have seen in our career of business activity. The bird flu scare was there in Maharashtra. Basically, the bird flu was declared in Maharashtra in a very small village. But the scare what it has resulted because of the electronic media and all has really shied away the consumer from consuming chicken and the eggs. With that, what has happened in 2004 and 5, there were not a single consumer who was consuming chicken or eggs. So we went for chicken melas, we have invited the concerned chief minister then, who have organized the chicken melas. We were serving chicken at free of cost, distributing eggs and all in the markets. But after some time, when the consumer got the awareness that the bird flu will not spread by consuming chicken, and having got the confidence of the consumer, we could grow it. As I told you, we have two companies. One is SR Hatcheries, the other is Rohini Minerals. SR Hatcheries is a broiler breeding farm, and Rohini Minerals caters the requirement of the feed for the breeding farm, and we are also into the feed sales. Rohini Minerals is a company which has started the production in 2004. Then we were selling around 2000 tons of feed. Now we are the largest selling company in the South India. We sell around 22,000-23,000 tons every month. Our turnover is around 650 crores. When we started, it was almost 19 crores. So we could grow to this stage only because of the technical expertise of the nutrition, the requirement of the farmers, the requirement of the birds also. Because we have the awareness of all these things, we could achieve this market share. What has happened, as I told you, in 2004-5, when we had the scare of the bird flu, basically, the industry grows by 10% in the layer segment and 15% in the broiler segment. So during those 2 years of 2004 and 5, when there was a bird flu incidence, the industry has not really grown. With that, what has happened, by the time we entered 2007 and 8, the anticipated growth of 10 and 15% every year, which was not there in 2004 and 5, and 5 and 6, has resulted a very big gap between the consumption, demand and supply. That has really shown the difference, and that is how we could get the best of the best prices in 2007-8, because there was no supply from our side. Yeah, India, we have the best of the best technical knowledge about the nutrition, but the problem is the equipment. We were not aware of the equipment what was being used elsewhere. So with the exposure what we had in the last 7-8 years, we went to different countries, we have seen their infrastructure. So we thought, why not we import that infrastructure and apply in Indian conditions. Initially, when this was discussed, we thought the cost of investment will go up and the cost of production also will go up. But we took a chance, we imported all the infrastructure, With that, what has happened is the investment has gone up, but the cost of production has come down because the efficiency has gone up. With the cheap manpower what we have, with the efficient infrastructure, we are one of the best producers now. Basically, this unit of Rohini Minerals and SRHIS, as I told you, the way we started our career in the business with a very meager amounts, what I always see is we have grown as a unit. You can ask any one of our employees who are in hundreds of members, all the employees will feel it as a family unit. I focus on that, saying that all of us should grow together. Any problem of any employee should be taken care by all of us. So what I keep telling my people also is, whenever there is a good occasion, it does not mean that everybody has to be there. But whenever there is some sad event in any of the families, everybody has to go there and take care of the man who is suffering. We hardly received any benefits from the government. We keep asking the government to help us in cutting the electricity tariff, asking them not to allow the exports and not to allow both the exports of raw materials of maize, corn and soya. But the government has never put a ban on that, because the requirement is more in India, but even then they allow the consumers to export, the producers to export. So that has really creating a problem for us, because the raw materials which are produced here are being exported at the cost of the poultry farmers. And we request the government to give us some electricity tariff, which the previous chief minister has accepted, but that has not come into implementation. We are really looking forward for that. Initially, when in 2004-05, when we started the company to cater the requirement of the poultry farmers about the nutrition, we were really not technically exposed to the nutrition what is there elsewhere. So today the bird consumes around 2 kgs of feed to give us a kg of chicken. When we entered, it was around 3.5 kgs. So looking into the technical expertise elsewhere and to, having taken these nutritions onto the board, now we are able to produce a kg of chicken with almost 1.6, 1.7 kgs of feed also. That has really helped us. The hurdles are part of any business. We cannot really expect any business to go have a smooth sale. So the same way happens in the livestock business also. The ups and downs are very, very common in livestock business. Because what happens in livestock is, whenever the market is good, we have a tendency to expand. That tendency of expansion is really creating a havoc in the livestock business. Because we keep expanding without informing the others, and because of the challenges, because of the competition among the big players, the understanding will not be a smooth one. So with that, what happens is we have too much of expansions, which will create an imbalance between the demand and supply. The supply will be more and immediately there will be a dip in the market. So these hurdles are very common for us. We generally place around 5 batches in 1 year of a broiler chicken. Out of 5 batches, we really do expect to have losses in 2 batches. We come out with the break-evens in 2 batches and we make money in 1 batch. This is the regular trend. But sometimes the loss can be in 3 batches, or sometimes the profits can be in 2 batches also. So the hurdles are bound to happen. This is what we are going to live with it. The major milestones, as I said before, is the business what we started with and the business what we are doing now, we have never anticipated this. This itself is a very big milestone for us. Now we are producing around 1.5 lakhs of chicks every day and we are selling around 25,000 tons of feed every month. This is the biggest milestone what any entrepreneur in poultry can expect. And we are really excited and happy about it. We have got a few awards for this, for these achievements also. We were selected by Microsoft, we have got the best SME award before. And with the success story of both in broiler breeding and the feed, now I have become the president of the Andhra Pradesh Broiler Breeders Association also. When we started our business in 1996, it was around 8,000 broiler breeders. Now we have about 4 lakhs plus broiler breeders. In 2004, when we started our feed operations, it was around 1,000 tons of feed every month. Now we have crossed 20,000 tons. The turnovers were around less than 10 crores in that year. Now we have crossed around 700 crores in these two activities. So with the growth what we have, with the staff what we have both in production, marketing, we are really excited. And we are highly indebted to Venkateshwar Hatcheries, with whom we are associated for so many years. Because the parents what we buy from them have the best
performance qualities what they give us, and we are really living up to their expectations, and they are giving much more than that for us. Quality is our commitment. That is the motto what we go with, and we are really lived up to the expectation of the poultry farmers, both in the broiler breeder segment and the feed operations also. We push all the staff to continuously give after sale service to the farmers who buy chicks and feed from us, so that as long as the farmer is happy, he will continue to be with us. So the hard work, the commitment, the quality, these are the few things what we keep focusing on, and that is a success story for us. As I said, the quality, commitment, hard work are the key factors for my success. So I think as an entrepreneur, I should give the same message to the people who like to come and join the business activities also. I am really proud the quality of chicken what we are giving to the farmers in Andhra now. Because in Andhra Pradesh, every one chicken out of the 10 chickens which is consumed is produced by me. So when we could produce such a good chicken with the best of the best nutrition, the farmer, the consumer really enjoys, and that is the biggest satisfaction what we have. Yeah, what I feel is, as far as the social this thing is concerned, I always live up to the expectations of my staff, which are in very big numbers. So more of social service I do to my staff, and I promise you and I can assure you that not a single farmer will not be, a single staff who is there with me for the last 20 years who is unhappy with us. You can ask and question anybody, they will be telling very high about us, because that is the satisfaction what they have. So the CSR, I keep focusing on that, but we do some activities in the breeding villages where we have tried for some ophthalmic this thing. We have anti-cancer checking also we have got done in few villages. And we take care of all the education of the students of the schools. We supply the books and shoes to most of the school going students there.
There's nothing much about the secrecy in our success. As I am telling you, it is only hard work, commitment, the quality, and we never compromise on the quality. However grave the situation may be, we have faced all ups and downs in the industry, but we have never compromised either in the chick quality or in the feed quality. Because when the conditions are worse, it is the best quality of feed or the chick which will help the farmer to survive a little bit. So there were too many occasions where our competitors have compromised for small petty things. But the success of this company is because of the quality what we maintained in dire situations also, which has brought the company's confidence in the farmers to a very great heights.